Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Satchidananda Rupaya, Vishvotpatyadihetave, Tapatraya Vinashaya, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Namaha, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Namaha. Om Yonta Pravishya Mama Vacham Imam Prasuttam Sanjeevayatya Akhila Shakti Dharasvadham Nam Anyashcha Hasta Charana Shravanatva Dadin Prana Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam Prana Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam Prana Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam.
We are in Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 71, and we were seeing that yesterday started Chapter 71, and here we saw that Shukdevji Maharaj is telling that to Parikshit that having got the counsel of Uddhavji Maharaj, Uddhav, who is very virtuous person like Shri Krishna, he is very wise, he is the knower of the truth, and when the various options are put in front of Lord Shri Krishna, that Jarathasan needs to be killed, and at the same time Yudhishthira wants to do Rajasuya Yagya, keeping and make the offering to Lord Krishna along with the other devatas, but mainly to Lord Krishna. At that time, naturally, the problem came, whom to listen to, what to do. All the courtiers were very, very inspired to fight and kill Jarasandha, because 17 times they had defeated Jarasandha, and the 18th time, Krishna Bhagavan, the Ranchodas, he ran away from the battlefield and settled down in Dwarkapuri, because they were living in Mathura before, isn't it? And so that khujli is there inside, that we have to take revenge from Jarasandha. So all the chieftains in the court, they were very, very inspired to fight. But at the same time, where to go? Should we go to Yudhishthir, to Indraprastha, who has just got his kingdom and wants to make an offering to the Lord, or to go to kill Jarasandha and fight with him in a war? At that time, Krishna Bhagavan, he looks at all the options. And it is important that whenever we make any decision, we must keep everyone in mind. But democracy is always of the fools. Democracy is not of the intelligent. Majority of the people in the world are uneducated and with no common sense. Then counsel should be taken from whom? Only from the educated, the wise ones. Then whom from? From the God or from Sant Mahatmas. From them, because they are Satya Sankalpa, they are Durdarshi, they can see far into the future. They know what consequences could come. They can come up with creative solutions, just like Uddhavji Maharaj comes up with a creative solution. And Krishna Bhagavan asks Uddhavji, and Uddhavji says, "Oh Lord, yes, both the points are very important, but I think we must go to Indraprastha and fulfill the wishes of Yudhishthir." Why Krishna had to go to Jarasandha to kill Jarasandha? Because one messenger from Jarasandha's country, Girivraja, from there he has come with a plea to Shri Krishna, not to anyone else, but to Shri Krishna, that there are thousands of kings who are captured by Jarasandh and kept in captivity, and he is going to give their bali. He is going to sacrifice them in order to satisfy the gods. So please, we are surrendered at your feet. Please come and rescue us. And what is the Lord's? Anyone who surrenders to him, the Lord always takes him under his wings. So both have to be. But if Krishna says, I will go to Yudhishthir, others will get angry. If he says, I will go to rescue the kings from the Jarasan, then Naradji, who has come with this message that Yudhishthir is inviting you to come and be a part of the Rajasuya Yagya, and he wants to give you the offer the oblations in your name. So now whom to, you can't dissatisfy anyone. Uddhavji Maharaj says, oh Lord, you must go to Indraprastha. And why you must go? Because that will give solace and an opportunity for all the kings that will be assembled there to see what your glory is. And also, by your going there, Yudhishthir's intention is not only offer the Rajasuya Yagya to you, but also to offer them, all the people who are ignorant, all the kings who are ignorant, offer them an opportunity to be under your grace. See the intention of our Yudhishthir. Yudhishthir's intention is not to become the king, emperor of the whole world, because he's already offering the yagya to Shri Krishna. He's not taking it for himself. He says, I want your blessings to be upon all the kings of this earth. And with that intention, so Uddhavji Maharaj says, please go there. But for the Raja Suya Yagya to be accomplished, there has to be a Digvijay. There has to be all the countries, all the kings must be accepting Yudhishthir as the supreme. Or at the same time, the Yajna Purusha is Shri Krishna. So they must accept Shri Krishna as the Yajna Purusha. So it will be possible. See, this is the beauty of Uddhava. He says that for that, before the Rajasuya Yagya is conducted, the army has to go out, and some kings will accept, some kings will not. And those who accept peacefully, great. If they do not, then the five brothers will have to go out and fight with them and make them to come under the lordship of Indraprastha kingdom. And eventually, when everyone has been won, I'm sure Jarasandh will be the main foe who will be left. And the only way Jarasandh can be defeated is not in a battle, because he has a huge army, and unnecessarily already 17 times millions and millions of people have died because of 17 wars. Not only on the mainly on the Jarasan side, because always Krishna and Balram used to go all by themselves to fight. 21 Akshavinis, imagine how many millions is that? That many, every time he used to come with 21 Akshavinis army, and Krishna and Balram used to kill every one of them and defeat him. But they used to leave Jarasandh alone. Why they used to leave Jarasandh alone? Why could they not kill him? Yes, they could. Then why?
You'll
correct me. Because if Jarasandh is left alone without killing him, he will go and collect all evil-minded people again and again, come and fight. 17 times he brings all the negative-minded people, hateful people, bad people, and comes to the war, and Krishna and Balram single-handedly destroy all of them. Millions and millions and millions. In the future, Kalki is going to do that. So this is the psychology behind it. So when police finds some bad element in the society, they keep a tab on him, leave him alone. He will go again, he will tell, oh yeah, I was caught, and he will find, acha, isko bhi pakad lo. The kingpin, they leave him alone, because he will keep
collecting, making the group again and again, and that way they can flush out the whole, all the negative elements within the society. And in this way, Uddhavji Maharaj says, O Krishna, after that, Jarasandh is a person who is very, very dedicated to Brahmins. He is a great householder. He loves taking care of all the household duties, just like you all. Atithi Devo Bhava, morning sandhya, afternoon sandhya, evening sandhya, reading of the scriptures, giving donations. He says he does the Brahman puja every day. He gives donations every day. He cannot be touched. He is very powerful. But just being a person who is doing all the right rituals every day and dana, dharma, etc., etc., Atithi Devo Bhava, does not qualify you or Jarasandh to be the ideal person. That does not qualify one person to be an ideal person. So what is the way? Because his acts are otherwise. He has captured all the kings. If he is very compassionate to the poor. But then why has he got all the kings in the, and why is he going to sacrifice them on the altar? So where is that goodness gone then? So inside, somewhere, the krurta is there. Huh? So Uddhavji Maharaj says, O Lord, you and Bhim, you go in the form of a Brahmin to Jarasandh and ask him in Dakshina, he will offer you something, ask what you want. At that time, you ask for a duel. Bhim must ask for a duel with Jarasandh. Only Bhim, the Vrikodara, who has an appetite of a wolf. Udara means stomach. Vrika means wolf. Wolf can keep eating. There. So, he's a wolf-like appetite. And he is also strong. Jarasandh is also 10,000 elephant strong strength. Bhim also has been gifted with a 10,000 strong elephant strength by the Nagaloka in his childhood. So with that, only Bhim. So when, and Jarasandh, he will not refuse a Brahmin if he asks something. In this way, many people will also be saved. There will be no unwanted killing, and only the decision will be made between Bhim and our Jarasandh. And when this prastav, this option is put in front, everyone agrees. And at that time, this is our problem also. And then Krishna Bhagavan, along with all his wives and children and sons and daughters, he goes to Indraprastha. So that begins, that we'll see. But here, we are also left in our life. Many times we have to make a decision. Where do we go? Which way do we take? Options are there. Should I leave the job or should I not leave the job? Should I get married or should I not get married? Should I be with Swamiji or should I be with my Akka? Which one? Akka or Swamiji? Both of them. She Uddhav Vacha. Finding one solution. Both of them. But many times in our life, we are at these crossroads, isn't it? Which way to take? Then how do you determine which way to go? How do you determine which way to go? To take you saw Matrix? To take the blue pill or the red pill? which pill are you going to take? Krishna Bhagavan had to decide after 17 wars with Jarasandh, 18th war, should I run or should I not run? But he made a decision, isn't it? To run away. He was ready to be, he was okay if people call him a coward, if people call him Ranchod. Are we here in the society to show that we are something, someone, don't mess with me? Or are we here to live? How do we know? Tell me, I'm asking you. How do we know what to do, what decision to take, in what manner to act? How do we come to know what is right when we are at these crossroads? And really, many major events must be there in your life, but really speaking, that crossroad is presenting to us every day, every moment. To watch the Harry Potter movie which is coming at 7 o'clock on TV, or go to Bhagwat. Today there is Harry Potter movie, you know that? You know? You don't know. Oh, you missed it, man. Think. How do you make the decision? I'm asking you people. Huh? But how do you decide what is priority? How do you determine what circumstances you don't create? Life presents you the circumstances. Understand this much. You do not create the circumstances. Life presents the circumstances. When you are presented with a circumstance, you have to make a decision now. So, based on what will you make the decisions? Is your intelligence so great that you can make the correct decision? Are you all-knowing like the Lord? Then how do you come to know? Then how do you make the decision? Certain things you can know, because when your child is eating, you want that child to eat good food and balanced food so that you can see the child's future. If he is eating only chips, there will be a problem in the future. If that child drinks soft drink, these are simple decisions, you know. but there are so many moments in life where we have to make major decisions. Whether to come to Australia and leave the parents in India, or live in India and lose the opportunity to come to Australia. Big decision, isn't it, for all of you? I had no problem. My parents were here. I came afterwards. But this is a conundrum which everyone has to solve. Then how do you solve it?
By the guidance of the wise people or the elders.
Good. Not elders.
Yeah.
Elders, yes, if they are wise. Yeah. Not necessarily elders. So did your parents say, beta, don't go? And you came. So where's the question of elders? Many times, parents are elders, yes. There are elders in the society also. But are they wise? That is the question. So, always take, when you have to make a decision, first is, think of the Lord. Second is, as given in the scriptures, follow the diktat of the scriptures. Which scriptures? Not written by Tom, Dick and Harry. The scriptures are the Puranas, the scriptures are the Vedas, the scriptures are the Mahabharata and Ramayana. Scriptures are the words of the saints and sages. For example, Vinay Patrika, which is written by Tulsidas ji, like the commentary on Bhagavad Gita by Jnaneshwar Maharaj. Amrita Anubhav, another treatise by Jnaneshwar Maharaj. Like this, so many saints have written something and given the secrets of life in their expositions. The best answer, why should I accept the scriptures? Why should I follow a book? This question will come into your mind. Why should I follow a book? I don't know who's written it. Some person has written it and unnecessarily confusing us. Giving us, study the scriptures, do the yoga, do the pranayama, don't desire. What is the point of living like this? Isn't it? Many people ask us this question. Why should I follow the scriptures? Because the scriptures are the speech of the Lord. That is why. Scriptures are not written by any man. Vedas and Puranas are not written by any man. Okay, Puranas are written down and remembered by Maharishi Vedvyas, who was himself the avatar of Lord Narayana. Mahabharata and Ramayana, they were written by, composed by a great rishis who had perfected themselves. And Vedas are Shruti Grantha. They were heard by the great rishis. They were revealed to them. And they are the speech of the Lord. So what should, our mind is always thinking about what can I get, what can I do, what can, am I should not have done that, I should have done that, I have to do this to be successful, I have to do that to be, at peace and content, continuously in this. And therefore he is forgetting the Lord because he is into doing and enjoying. Ego expresses as doership and enjoyership. There is nothing called ego. It's from its expression, we believe there is something called ego. The one who expresses as the doer and the enjoyer is the egoistic personality. But actually, if you look for it, it is not there. But you are not looking for it. That ego only survives because it is thinking about the world. When that ego starts thinking about itself, who am I? Or it starts thinking about the Lord, the ego vanishes. That simple. But our energy, our power, our potential, our shakti is being utilized only to think about the world. If at all we have to think, then what should we think? If our mind is, what is the mind? Thoughts, isn't it? Mind, just like eyes cannot do but see, ears cannot do anything but hear, mind cannot do anything but think. Then what is the quality of thoughts that must be programmed in this mind? Should they be of the world? Should they be of, I don't hate you, I love you, I'm jealous of you, and I want whatever you have is mine, and what is mine is also mine. Are these the thoughts that we must cultivate? See, think about it very simply, commonsensically think. So if at all we have to think, what should we think about? Because thinking is also an art. So what should we think? Our thoughts in our mind should reflect the thoughts in the scriptures. So what is the difference between Narad Muniji, Vashishtha Muniji, or all the various great masters? They are continuously thinking about the divine theme. And we are continuously thinking about the worldly theme. Worldly theme can never give us contentment. Divine theme is of the nature of contentment. You don't need to become content. It is of the nature of contentment. And it is not other than you. Because ego vanishes when you start thinking of the divine. See? Hello, man. Equation clear? So in this manner, tenth verse we had done. So here, then what does it mean to be thinking of the Lord all the time, to be surrendered to the Lord all the time, to be subservient to the Lord all the time? What does it mean for a devotee? It means that everything that is happening in my life, everything, all the events that are taking place are happening by His grace, by his will, not my will.
If that is the case, a devotee thinks, he does not complain, he becomes complaint free. Why? Because everything is the Lord, everything is being done by the Lord. Lord is only bringing all the situations, Lord is only taking away all the situations. I did not create the day, I did not create the night. God creates the day, then he removes the day and brings the night, then he removes the night and brings the day again.
By the Lord's will,
the waker wakes up in the morning, then he goes to sleep at night. Sometimes we want to sleep, but the sleep doesn't come, isn't it?
Sometimes we
enjoyed some dream and we want to dream again. It doesn't come back again.
Where's that girl gone?
Where's that car gone? Where's that toy gone? Isn't it?
Or we saw a beautiful place
in meditation by the mountains, a very calm waters, and I'm sitting in a nice hut, sitting in meditation on a rock by the lake. Ah, so peaceful. And there I was getting this fragrance also, and all the flowers everywhere around. It was heaven.
And next time I go into meditation, and I want the same experience all over again. And for the next rest of my life, I keep looking for it, but it will never come.
Then whose grace? The dreams, the fantasies, the thoughts. Thoughts are also coming by his grace only. Last time we saw, isn't it? Breathing is
happening by his grace.
Heartbeat is happening by his grace.
So if the blood is running around,
are you saying, acha, now I have to push, man, blood has not reached my heart yet. Do you say that I have to push?
Similarly, waking, dreaming and deep sleep, this is your complete experience of one day, it is also happening by his grace only.
Birth has also happened by his grace only. Death will also happen by his grace only. Then how come life between birth and death is by my will? It has to be by his grace only. Simple equation.
But we live in a fool's world. We think, no, after birth,
I am someone, I am something, and I can achieve, I can change the course of my life. Yes, you can, but it should be the correct one.
What is the course of the life that you have to change? You have to drop the individuality, dissolve the individuality, to recognize that you are
of the nature of the divine itself. That is the course of action. If you initiate it in your life, then there will be peace and contentment. Otherwise, only misery. You will be only a complaint box.
See? With this knowledge, if you
jump into the world, fantastic.
This is what Krishna Bhagavan did every morning. He got up in the morning. The first thing he did
when he get up in the morning, wash his teeth, go to toilet, sit down in meditation 2 hours before sunrise. Why? Before he jumps into the world, he wants to connect with himself. Does he need? No. He's doing it to show us that our day must begin with
recognizing
who we really are. Am I a husband, husband, wife, daughter, sister, brother, mother? Or am I a individual? Or am I actually divine? That's what the scriptures
say, that I am actually divine.
So seek the divine, surrender yourself, merge into it, and from that point, then jump out into the world. Then your interaction with the world will not be the way it is right now. Right now, the world is the bhogya vastu. I have to enjoy the world. Why have you come to Australia? To enjoy, isn't it?
I didn't ask you, I'm asking your akka.
Why have you come to Australia? To enjoy Australia, to explore Australia, to see Australia, to see your relatives, to maybe
play with Bhageshri, huh? And Saket. It's a bhogya vastu. Oh, let's go to that restaurant, let's enjoy that.
Restaurant, bhogya vastu. We get married, bhogya vastu. The opposite partner is a bhogya vastu. We eat food, bhogya vastu. And something to be enjoyed. And as long as our interaction with the world is with this intention that I have to enjoy the world,
you can never, never, never be at peace in life. Impossible. Then how will this peace that we all are seeking, will it come from? How will this deep bliss that we enjoy in the deep sleep, or that bliss that we enjoy on the seat of meditation by being nobody, we are nobody in the meditation if we have reached that stage, even for a second. And we know, yeah, something touched me, it was so joyful. But when we come out in the world, why we are not able to maintain that? Because we still consider the world to be a bhogyavastu, something to be enjoyed. We are not seeing it to be the Lord. See, when the world, the parichinna, the world, that which you see, that which you are experiencing, what you are experiencing? The world. And that which is beyond everything, the Lord. When you start seeing that Lord as the world, when you start seeing the Lord as the world, or the world pervaded by the Lord, whichever way, that divine, the creator, and this world is the created. Right now for us, these two are separate. We are searching for the creator and we are living in the created, isn't it? That is our situation right now. But when our vision comes that this creator that I am seeking on the seat of meditation is the same as the created in which I am a part of, this body is a part of, when they become one, story over. That is realization, God realization. Right now we are living in, we are separating everything. So in this manner, whom should we give importance to? See, for an example is taken. An example is Bharatji Maharaj. When Bharatji came back from Kaikeya Pradesh in Ramayana, when he came back from Kaikeya Pradesh, he found that Ramchandraji has been given the vanvas, and his mother has kept the throne for him, and the father has already passed away. How much time did Bharat take to decide what should be his course of action? He was at a crossroad of life. Should he become the king or not? How much time did he take? When his mother told, when he came into the room, and that Sumandhara is, not Sumandhara, what is it? Mandhara. Not Sumandhara, Mandhara is there. Mandhara is there, and the mother says, see, beta, son, I have kept the, the throne for you, and I sent your brother to Vanvas, to the exile. What did Bharat say? What was the decision of Bharat? Why? Should he be a dutiful son? Think. Should he be the dutiful son? Or should he be the dutiful brother? Pull both sides, isn't it? For a normal person. Should I come to Australia or should I stay in India and lose the opportunity? Pull. So what do you do? What did Bharatji do? What did Bharatji do? He had everything very clear in his mind, because he is Dharmatma. Bharatji is Dharmatma. He knows. What does he know? He knows these parents, this my mother, and all this kingdom, this mother is my mother only for this life. Lives are many. So why should I get attached to her? This throne is for this life. Why should I get attached to the throne? sit here. Hey, sit down. Ah, toilet. Both of you together?
He is going to show.
Security guard. So, so all these relatives, this father, this mother, this brother, this throne, this kingdom, this Bharatji has achieved, got it in this kingdom, this lifetime, isn't it? But there are many lifetimes. So do I get attached to this set of circumstance and take advantage, or do I get attached to, or do I surrender to, do I become subservient to the Lord, who is not only in this lifetime but forever? See the difference? And immediately at that very moment, he became so disgusted with his mother. मातृ देवो भव. अरे माता अगर शूर्पनखा जैसी है या कैकेयी जैसी है तो फिर भागो वहां से. इफ द मदर इज नॉट इनवोकिंग, द फादर इज नॉट इनवोकिंग, द रिलेटिव्स आर नॉट इनवोकिंग, फ्रेंड्स आर नॉट इनवोकिंग इन यू द लव फॉर द लॉर्ड, रन अवे फ्रॉम देम. नो पॉइंट स्टेइंग देयर, कीप देम एट आर्म्स डिस्टेंस. Otherwise, you are going to get caught up in the same cycle. All that is good, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. But here we see, it is not only in this. Mahabharata also, so many examples are there. Bharat Maharaj immediately goes to Ramchandra Ji and surrenders at his feet. He says, please come back. Isn't it? Another example, Mirabai, who was being troubled by her in-laws because within 1 year of the marriage, the husband passed away, and they blamed, because you are manhoos, because of you our son passed away. She said, before marriage only I told my husband is Krishna, what can I do? So he said, okay, you're Krishna, you are married to him, wash dishes, clean the house. And they were troubling him, abusing her. In not only by word but hitting her, and she was very, very disturbed. But at the same time, whenever difficulties come in life, if you are sincere, your love for the Lord and your surrender to the Lord increases. And in that happening, she wrote a letter to, in the same period of time, was sage Tulsidas. She wrote to him that, oh, Tulsidas ji Maharaj, this is the situation, what do I do? Is it my duty towards my in-laws more important, or what should I do? How do I get out of it? This is our question also, many times in our life. And that great Tulsidas ji Maharaj, he immediately writes a letter back, my dear Meera, anyone who keeps you away from the Lord, don't worry. More important than the in-laws, more important than anything else in the world is the love for the Lord. And when she gets that letter, she moves out of that place and goes away. She traveled quite a bit around the various kingdoms that time. See? So how do you make this? The whole thing was, how do you make decisions in life? How do you make decisions in life? By following the scriptural diktat. Scriptures are not, and again, scriptures are within the Vedas. It will tell you to do the homa, it will tell you to do the, dana dharma, it will tell you to do upasana, it will tell you to sit in meditation, it will tell you to do pranayam. Which one will you follow? Start somewhere. Be intelligent about it. And intelligence is not how much you know. Intelligence means common sense. Common sense. Don't allow yourself to be programmed by the society.
don't allow yourself to be programmed by the scriptures also. But using the scriptures, if your attention is on that infinite Lord, only if your attention is on the infinite Lord, you will not get lost in the scriptures. Then the scriptures will help you to come out of them so that the goal becomes accessible. So in this manner, with these examples, we see that whenever we are at crossroads, we must take the support of the scriptures or the support of the Sant Mahatmas. Because why we take, now we have talked about scriptures, why Sant Mahatmas? Why should we take the support of Sant Mahatmas or seek for an answer from them? Because they are Satya Sankalpa. Satya Sankalpa means that if they say something, it happens. When we say something, why doesn't it not happen? And when they say something, why does it happen? The example of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, the teacher of Swami Vivekananda. One mother went to him and asked him, Oh, Sadhu, can you tell my son not to eat rasagulla? Immediately, without any thought, he says, come next week. Again she came next week. Again he said, come next week. Again she went away, again she came. Third week again. After 3 weeks, he said, son, don't eat rasagulla. He said, okay. He said, okay. Now the mother was in trouble. Why? For 3 weeks you called me, you know how far, 50-60 kilometers away, 3-4 buses I have to change and come. Why couldn't you, if only one sentence was to tell, son, don't eat rasagulla, why couldn't you tell it the first time? Baba, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, because mother, I was eating rasagullas, it took me 3 weeks not to be disturbed by the presence or absence of rasagulla. And now that it does not create a reaction in my mind, now I am qualified to tell your son, don't eat rasagulla, and he will not eat it now. Because who is Satya Sankalpa? Satya Sankalpa, who has got no desire in the world. God is Satya Sankalpa, Mahatmas are Satya Sankalpa. We don't have Satya Sankalpa, we have Vikalpa. We have one project after the other. Aaj ek ghar banayenge, fir zameen khareedenge, fir job dhundenge, fir naye kapde banayenge, fir India jayenge, fir Australia jayenge, fir ye karenge, fir wo karenge. We are always on to something, isn't it? By will. And if nothing is, oh yaar, I'm feeling at loss. What happened? Kuch karne ko nahi hai. Acha, project karo. Bibi se jhagda karo. First time. प्रोजेक्ट खत्म कर गया देखो ये छोटी छोटी चीजें सिंपल चीजें हैं एक बार समझ गए तो समझ गए सुधर गए नहीं तो उसी लूप में घूमते रहेंगे विल कीप गोइंग राउंड एंड राउंड एंड राउंड एंड राउंड एंड राउंड So in this way, the best way to make decisions, that's why all the great kings, including Ramchandra ji, including Dasharath Maharaj, including the Kauravas and the Pandavas, they did not make decisions independently. Whenever they made decisions independently, all those kings have gone and mixed with the dust. They have been defeated. Chandragupta Maurya, whom did he take counsel of? Chanakya, the wise man. What was his greatness? He didn't want anything for himself. Isn't it? Vashishtha Maharaj, the guru of the Suryavansh. What? He is the advisor. What did he want from the Suryavanshis? Nothing. So seek someone. A wise man is he who does not want anything in return, who is self-existing. He is a power in himself. He does not become more because you give him some dakshina or you give him food, and neither he becomes less. He doesn't ask you. It is his duty to ask for bhiksha. But he is not dependent on that bhiksha or that dakshina. He is not. So such people who do not have an axe to grind in this world, who do not want name, fame, who do not have any projects in the world, such people we must go to ask for advice. I am stuck here, what can I do? But we think we have built one or two or three houses, we have got a good job which is paying 80, 90 grand, 100 grand, and we have become invincible in life. See? By luck, you got a good wife or a good husband, very, very dutiful children. And we think we have become invincible, we are better than the others. Our Jarasandh was also like that. He was an ideal householder. Better than you all can ever be. Ideal, because he was a king. You are not a king yet. You may be a property owner, but you are not a king yet. Huh? So he was a householder. He used to do all his nitya karma. He was compassionate towards the poor. He gave lot of dana dharma, charity. But he was, what was his virus in him? He was not surrendered to the, he was surrendered in one way, we will see now, because he remembers that. But he does not consider Krishna to be God, that's all. He doesn't have that vision. Because ego is very high, that I have done everything. And therefore I must surrender. If I decide he is God, he is God. That is his problem. If I decide you are a Mahatma, then you are a Mahatma. If I don't decide, if I not said that you are a Mahatma, you cannot be a Mahatma. That is the Jarasandh's problem. And that big ego has come because of his invincibility, because of his body identification. His body cannot be killed by anyone. With this, we move ahead now in the story. We'll chant the Shri Shuka Uvacha Ityudhva Vacho Rajan Sarvato Bhadramachyutam Devarshir Yadu Vriddhascha Krishnascha Pratyapujayan Adhadishat Prayanaya Bhagavan Devaki Sutaha Bhrutyandaruka Jaitradin Anugnyapya Gurun Vibuhu Nirgamavyavarodhan Swan Sasutan Saparichadan Sankarshanam Anugnyapya Yadurajam Chashatruhan Sutopanitam Swaratham Aruhad Gurudadvajam Sutopanitam Swaratham Aruhad Garuda Dvajam Tato Rathad Vipa Bhatasadikna Nayakaihi Karalaya Parivruta Atmase Naya Mrudanga Bheriya Nakashanka Gomukaihi Praghosha Yoshita Kukubho Nirakramata Nruvajikanchana Shibika Bhirachutam Sahatma Japati Manu Suvrata Yayuhu Barambara Bharana Vilepanastrajaha San Suvrata Nrubhira Sicharma Pani Bihi Naroshtra Gomahesha Karashwataryan Karenubhi Parijanavara Yoshitaha
स्वलंकृता कटकुटिकम्बलास्कलम्बा कटकुटिकम्बलाम्ब राद्युपस्करा ययूरधिष्युज्य सर्वतः बलं बृहद्ध्वजपट छत्रचामरैः वरायुधाभरणकिरीटवर्मभिः देवांशुभेस्तु मुलारवं तिमुलरवं बभौ रवेः यथार्णवक्षुभिततिमीलिङ्गिलोर्मिभिः अधो मुनिर्यदुपतिना सभजितः प्रणम्यतं हृदि विदधद् विहाय सा निशम्य तद्व्यवसित माहतार्हणो मुकुंद संदर्शन निवृतेन्द्रियः. सो हियर इन द 11th इन द 71st चैप्टर 11th वर्स सुखदेव जी महाराज इज सेइंग दैट that Uddhav ji, after listening to the words of the Uddhav ji, all the elders in the court, in the assembly, where Krishna Bhagwan, Balram ji, Ugrasen ji, Satyaki, Krutavarma, and all the elders and all the generals were sitting, all of them agreed to the counsel given by Uddhav ji Maharaj. Now see, everything that Uddhav ji has said will come true. Why? Because he is Satya Sankalpa. He is Tattva Darshi. He knows who he is. He is surrendered at the feet of the Lord. So to show, because some people people, so that people don't believe that it is Krishna is hijacking the issue, you know, that is what happens sometimes. You put a party, just now some people are going to India, they said, Swamiji, bhiksha khila ke question poochte hai, kya question? Swamiji, kaise karna hai, ye karna hai, wo karna hai, hum India ja rahe hai, 3 hafte ke liye, kya kare hai? Maine kaha, chale jao, gaadi pakdo aur niklo. नहीं नहीं वहाँ पे ऐसे कैसे कौन सा सीक्वेंस करें क्या करें. मैंने कहा यार तुम अपने हिसाब से करो. नहीं नहीं आप बताओ. मैंने कहा मैं क्या बताऊँ है ना. पर नहीं स्वामी जी प्रॉब्लम इज देर आर ऑल ऑफ अस आर सीनियर सिटीजन्स एंड एवरीवन हैज ओपिनियन व्हाट टू डू फर्स्ट. मैंने कहा एंजॉय द ओपिनियन.
सबके सब.
सो इफ first thing is everyone in that group must have respect to the one who is organizing the group, isn't it? And that person who is organizing the group must be having that power, must be selfless, only then people will listen to him. But if you have a itch that I have to do something, then they will not listen to you. If you are not able to communicate to that person, others, that what is the best way, then they will not listen.
If you are going to take a stand, अच्छा
तुम ऐसे बोलते हो नहीं मैं ऐसे करता हूँ मैं organize करूँ मैं ये करूँ फिर नहीं होएगा. And it is not a question of democratic conclusion also, because 15 people going, all 15 wanting, no, we should go there first, we should go there, then you will not go anywhere. Then you will go to the airport. At the airport you will fight with each other
for 15 days and then come back again. Exactly the same thing happened in this assembly.
All the people are having different ideas, what to do, what not to do. So at that time, Krishna Bhagwan, not taking a position, say, because everyone respects the Mahatma, Uddhav, and take his suggestion.
And see his solution. Everyone agreed straight away. There was no question.
There was no argument. And therefore,
then the counsel that he gave was absolutely to the dot.
And
Even the Devarshi Narada approved of it, and Shri Krishna also approved of it. And then all the elders in the court, in the assembly hall, they also approved of it. And who were there? The Ugrasenji was there, Krishna's father Vasudevji was there, Satyaki was there, and all others. And in this way, after that, Krishna Bhagwan immediately started to prepare for the journey. And there it is told that he went out, and Daruka is the charioteer of Krishna. And along with his wives and along with his sons, they took the permission from Ugrasen and Balrama, they put all their luggages in the bullock carts, and they started on the journey to Indraprastha. And he didn't go by himself. He took the Narayani Sena with him. Why? Because anything can happen. He has to defeat Jarasandha when the war comes. When the Rajasuya, before Rajasuya, they have to conquer all the land, so they will need the strength. And this chariot of Krishna Bhagwan, it has the Garuda on the Garuda Dhaja. And in this way, he set out, and along with his generals, along with the chariots, elephants, horses, everyone, they started. And as the whole the congregation is moving towards Indraprastha, it is not they're moving in silent and some. They are all excited. They are all happy. The conches, the kettle drums, the nagada, yes, sab baj rahe hain, and they are singing and joyfully. It has to be a joyful trip. They're not going in meditation to some people bhajan chal raha hai, they're in meditation. Bhajan ke samay bhajan karo, aur jab bhajan kar rahe hain ye chheenk rahe hote hain. Nahi, jab meditation ho raha hai, they're moving around and everything. Jab bhajan chal raha hai, they're doing meditation. Like some people, some children, you go to Chinese restaurant, they want pasta. You go to pasta restaurant, they want Chinese. Like that. When bhajan is going on, do meditation. When meditation is going on, they will do bhajan. When satsang is going on, they'll be talking. And when we say, now you talk, then... Have you seen? Here also it has happened many times. Ye sab baithe hain chote chote sare. And all of them were very well attired, in the best clothes, with all the ornaments. Are raste pe ja rahe ornaments, gold ornaments, gems. Yes, they got Narayani Sena with them. They got Lord Krishna security with them. Security is full. They are not afraid. And they got all the sandal paste, and the Lord is along with his wives. How 16,000 wives. All of them are there with him. And in this way, and behind them is the entire caravan of all other wives, the dasis, the courtesans, and the clothes, and the mats, and the tents, and the blankets, and the clothes, and everything that is on the camels, elephants, and bullock carts. All that is coming behind them. This huge army, with all the noise, it was going through, and continuously all the army. It's not a silent one, because with the shields, with the bows and arrows, and with this, when they have the kya bolte hain to talwar ko kis mein rakhte hain,
mayam,
English mein bolna,
English mein Narayan.
Narayan. Sword is kept in what? In its sheath. So it's continuously clanking against the body armor, it's making noise. Hey, So full this noise is going on there, and in the midst of Narayan. Narayan should know everything. At least live up to it. He should live up to it. Usko yaad dila rahe hai ki tu hai kaun, hai na? Bhul gaya hai.
Kannada medium
hai. Kannada medium hai. Abhi English bhi to bol raha, abhi Hindi bol raha.
Narayan knows everything.
Narayan should know everything. And if it is not, keep invoking. And the sage Narada, he was also very delighted at heart at the sight of Shri Krishna, and having heard the decision what Shri Krishna had taken by listening to Uddhava, he also by Akash Marg went his way, keeping the form of the Lord in his heart. Narad Muniji has got one beautiful ability.
And what is that?
He is ever surrendered to the Lord. Ever surrendered. You will find him doing so many things in his, because he cannot stay in one place for more than a few minutes. He keeps moving around the world. Because it is not his decision. It happens, isn't it?
His movement of, he is not deciding
that I must go there or I must go there. It is all by Lord's will that he finds himself in a particular place at a particular time with a particular person, isn't it?
Your mind is also like that.
It keeps going here and there.
Your mind is also going here and there.
But Narad Muniji, his mind is ever focused on the divine form, Chaturbhuj.
No, Ananta Shayana Narayana,
on him. And whatever he does is always as an offering to the Lord, and his intention is always wherever life places him or takes him, he brings that. His intention is that person must get the darshan of the Lord or the grace of the Lord. Is that our intention when we move around in the world? Socho, Zara. Is that our intention? Our intention must be this, that yena kena prakarena, some way or the, somehow, we must bring out, just like he did just now. Maybe he did it in joke, or maybe he was sincere. Narayan. So that only he knows, and how he took it, only he knows.
We can only have a laugh at it,
isn't it? If he was
sincere, chalo yaar, mere ko to pata nahi.
Narayan, are koi naam, Narayan naam ka to koi hai.
Remember Ajamil story?
Huh? What happened in Ajamil story? That that
well-educated Kshatriya.
In Vedas, he was well educated in Vedas, Brahmin fellow falls in love with a tribal girl and
he is thrown out of the village,
and he is attracted to the body of this tribal girl,
and he is living like a chandal
outside the village. Nobody gives him food. He is from
collecting whatever he can in the
jungle. He is subsisting his
family, and eventually after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9th child.
In the 9th child, by Lord's grace, he names him Narayana. He has forgotten all the scriptures, everything, because totally besotted with this woman.
And that name Narayana,
now his death is coming close, and at the time of death, he is calling his son. Just like he was
calling for this Narayan for answer. He was calling his son, Narayan, Narayan,
because he saw Yamadutas coming and coming to take his soul, take him.
And he called Narayan.
And at that very moment, the son came or not come, that is not given. But Narayan Bhagwan, who was in Vaikuntha, he immediately sends his Vishnu Dutas, that go, someone is calling, go and attend to him straight away. And this
fellow is in his last breaths,
and he's seeing the dialogue between the Yamadutas, the messengers of death, and the messengers of Lord Narayana. And what is the messenger discussion?
He said, this fellow is Brahmin, but living a life of licentiousness.
He has studied scriptures, but he is not following anything in this. He should be following all the nitya karmas. He has not done any nitya karma.
And they give a list of all the wrongs that he has done. Vishnu Duta say, we don't know what he has done and what he has not done. We know only one thing. What is that? He took the name of our Lord.
So he is qualified to come to Vaikuntha. He has taken the name of the Lord with his last breath. So he is qualified to come to Vaikuntha. We don't know. And this conclusion that we are telling you, that he has taken the name of the Lord and is qualified for Vaikuntha, even your boss, Yamaraj, he knows. Go and ask him. We are waiting here. We will not go anywhere. You can leave all your, one person can go and ask Yamaraj, your boss. So that person goes,
Yamaraj says, what? He took
the name of Narayana. No, I can't do it. It's out of my jurisdiction now. So they come back. They're
okay. And this fellow, the Ajamil, he's watching this whole dialogue.
And then when the Yamadutas go away, Vishnu Duta say, ah, he says, I have done all so much wrong, I want to repent. And they say, yes, the way you are qualified to come to Vaikuntha, but not in the state that you are in right now. Now we give you an opportunity, we give you your life back, lead your life piously, live life dedicated to Lord Narayana, meditate, contemplate, whatever has to be done, but in this lifetime or next lifetime, but you have to purify yourself. And they give. And immediately,
the moment he finds his, he's old.
The moment he gets his life back, immediately he leaves his body, his family, goes away into a jungle, meditates
and attains
Vaikuntha. Because what was the initial reason that he got into family? Lust. Not love. Not an offering to the Lord. Marriage should be an offering to the divine. A conception of a child must be an offering to the divine. Not a product of a lust. When it is like that, the society will become the way it is becoming right now.
Children don't know who their father is. Children don't know who their mother is. No, mother they know, sorry. But many of them don't even know that. See? So, even that conceiving a child should be an offering to the Lord.
Then you see what a beautiful soul will be attracted to your womb. See? This example we see
in Prahlad's life, isn't it? When Prahlad's
mother, Kayadhu, right? Kayadhu. Her husband was Hiranyakashipu.
And that Hiranyakashipu,
Rakshasa. She is also Rakshasi. But when he has gone to meditate on Lord Brahmaji, Indra Bhagavan comes because he is jealous that this Hiranyakashipu has become more powerful than me. So he comes, kidnaps,
is pulling Kayadhu by her hair
and taking her away to put in the prison in
Swargalok. At that time Naradji comes.
He says, where are you doing? You are a Indra. This act doesn't suit you. But he says, this
Hiranyakashipu is this. When he comes back and if he doesn't find his wife, he will be broken. And that time I'll kill this fellow.
But because he is wrong, what wrong has his wife done? No, I will kill her womb. I'll kill the child in the womb only. Indra is saying, he's the bloody jealous fellow.
Gods doesn't mean that they are good.
They are also opposite of asuras. They are also jealous when their seat is
in jeopardy.
He says, I'll kill the womb, the fetus in the womb itself. So there will be no future generations of Hiranyakashipu.
So Narad Muni says,
you don't worry, I'll take care of her. This is not the right. And Narad Muni is elder brother of Indra, isn't it?
So he does. And while the baby is in the womb,
the
Narad Muniji is whole day Om Narayana Namaha, Om Narayana Namaha. He's chanting the Bhagavatam, he's singing the bhajans, he's chanting the name of the Lord. And when Prahlad is born, he is by birth, he is devotee of the Lord. The first word that he utters is Om Narayana Namaha or Vishnave Namaha, whatever. See, this is prenatal education. This happened because the mother also started enjoying. She didn't want, when Hiranyakashipu came, she didn't want to go back. She says, can I stay here for one more year? Because the child is coming up very nicely. See? And whom do we expose our, when we are, we means the ladies, when they are pregnant, what do they expose themselves to? Saas bhi kahi bahuti. All the serials. Or the horror movies. Or Harry Potter.
WhatsApp.
आजकल मेरी मम्मी को अच्छी तरह से पकड़ के रखा है WhatsApp. बहुत जवाब देती है. सुबह उठते ही पहले WhatsApp को कितने मैसेज आए हैं. Some new toy she has found. But think, when you offer like this, so in then what is the type of soul that she attracted? Should it not will that fetus, that soul which came into the womb of Kayadhu, should it not have some qualities of Hiranyakashipu? How come such a great devotee of the Lord came about? Nothing is impossible, but our attitude has to be right. So our whole life, if it is happening, marriage is happening, let it happen. Children are happening, let them happen. But our attitude, our surrender, our dedication to the Lord must not wane. Everything, every action in our life must be as an offering to the Lord. Then what you have to do in life, what decisions you have to do in life, they will be revealed to you. You don't have to go to anyone. And every time answer may come, may not come, but because your faith is so drud, so firm in the Lord, that answer may come by a person named Narayana. Answer may come from outside, and you have the intellectual acumen to recognize that this is the right answer. Because the nature is nothing but the Lord himself, isn't it? But when your attention is on the Lord, whichever way the Lord decides, he will give you an answer. It may be as an inner conscience, it may be as a situation, it may be as a word from someone, and it will just strike you. It may be from the Mahatmas, but till you are not got there, seek out the scriptures. Based on the scriptures, make your decisions. Based on the words of the Mahatmas, make your decisions. They may not sound very palpable initially. They may not. Initially you will feel, oh hey, yaar, Swami ji ne bol diya, aise bol diya, aise kaise? Ya kisi Mahatma ne bol diya? You know, Jai Shri Amma is there, you know, Jai Shri Raghavan. Her daughter is in States and her husband is some surgeon in some Dallas hospital in America. Amachi went last time and she said, enough of working here, you have made enough money, now come to Amritpuri and be a consultant in our hospital. And they did not think twice. Immediately, for last 12 years, 13 years they have been living there, her husband has been there for so long. Her daughter has been since she was very young kid, they have been living in Australia. They have not lived in India at all. Not in Kerala. Kerala is so hot, humid. But because Ammachi said it, the faith that they have in her, immediately they packed up everything, and last year they went to Amritpuri. She is working in the Ammachi's administration and he is working at the hospital. And she is getting, they are getting paid, but they don't want too much because they already have made enough. Now they want to serve. See, this is ideal. And Ammachi, for us, a Mahatma comes and says something, arre, isko kya pata hai? Samiji, aapko pata nahi hai, ye life alag hoti hai.
You don't know how to deal with people. You don't know. You know, we have lived life, we have experience, we are married, you don't know how people are. Acha?
Tumhe zyada pata hai. People talk like this.
I'm telling you what people talk. Tum kuch bol rahe the?
No, I was going to say that. अब जैसे आज हम की हम बात कर रहे थे कि भगवान के पार्षद आए और उन्होंने बोला कि ठीक है, वी गिव यू दैट एक्सटेंच एंड देन यू हैव टू गो एंड ना लीड इट. तो ऐसे ही तो महात्मा आते हैं ना. तो फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑनवर्ड्स
एब्सोल्युटली फॉर व्हाट रीजन महात्माज कम इनटू योर लाइफ. तुमने कभी बुलाया था क्या किसी को? तुमने कभी बुलाया था किसी को? तुम्हारे किसी ने मेरे को कल बोला क्या, स्वामी जी I am taking the name of the Lord, but I am not getting any experience. मैंने कहा तू बेवकूफ, सबसे बड़ा बेवकूफ है.
कहते हैं क्यों स्वामी जी, ऐसे मेरे को एकदम से फुस कर रहे हो, सबसे बड़ा बेवकूफ है मैं. मेरा तो नाम जब चल रहा है, मेरा ये चल रहा है, मेरा वो चल रहा है,
पर मेरे को कोई अनुभव ही नहीं आ रहा. भगवान मेरे को ये तो पता लगे. आई शुड कम टू नो दैट आई एम मूविंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन टेकिंग द नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड. वी आर गोइंग फॉर अ वॉक.
The most stupid fellow. You don't have common sense. Now why? I should not. Then
Swamiji, ऐसे मत बोलो.
कोई और मेरे साथ होता उस समय.
Third person was there. Swamiji, how can you speak like that to him? मैं उससे बात कर रहा हूँ. तेरे को क्या problem है?
We become suddenly, you know.
Swamiji should not speak negative. अरे तुम कौन होते हो मेरे और उसके बीच में? It's between me and him. I said, change your vision.
By God's grace, you came to Australia.
By God's grace, you got a job in Sydney. By God's grace, from Sydney, you shifted to Melbourne.
By God's grace, you came to my satsang.
By God's grace, now Bhagavad Gita, 11 chapters have happened in your house. And you are saying that God is not giving you experience, that you are moving in the right direction. God has given us everything, but we are not ready to look at it. We want something specific. What we have decided in our mind, that this is what I want to experience. Mere ko na wo andar ka thrill chahiye, mere ko andar ka na samadhi chahiye, mere ko andar ka na dhad 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 jab sharir hilna chahiye, aankhein ghumni chahiye, tab phir theek hoga. All that foolishness, man.
Isn't it? That's what
everyone, I was also like that. But start seeing your whole life as happening. When you start looking at the whole life, everything is happening by His grace. तुम्हारे जीवन में कहाँ पे कौन से महात्मा आए थे अभी तक? सत्संग चल रही है, personal you can discuss your issues, problems, साधना के. Great महात्मा, other महात्मास come. घर में बैठे बिठाए अम्मा जी आ जाती है, घर में बैठे बिठाए गुरुजी आ जाते हैं, घर में बैठे बिठाए सब वीडियो पे सब कुछ दिख जाता है आजकल. और यू आर सेइंग दैट यू आर नॉट हैविंग एक्सपीरियंस,
देन यू आर द मोस्ट मिजरेबल पर्सन ऑन दिस प्लैनेट. नॉट हिम, एवरी वन ऑफ अस. इफ वी आर नॉट रेडी टू सी हाउ ग्रेटफुल द लॉर्ड इज
दैट ही हैज प्रोवाइडेड द एंटायर फॉर आवर बेनिफिट, so that we can evolve ourselves, we can be dedicated to Him, and yet we are saying that He is not there. Oh, isse buddhu aur kaun ho sakta hai yaar. So don't go after specific experiences.
Look at, if they come, good, otherwise have the gratitude. Look,
thank you Lord for where you have placed me. हर सैटरडे सत्संग हो जाती है, हफ्ते में भी
तुम यूट्यूब पे सब सुन लेते हो स्वामी जी का. देर आर अदर सो मेनी सत्संग आर गोइंग ऑन
एंड यू आर सेइंग दैट
पुअर मी, मेरे को कुछ अनुभव ही नहीं हो रहा है.
देखो राजदूतम वाचेदम भगवान प्रीणयन गिरा मा भैष्ट दूत भद्रम वो घातयिष्यामि मागधम इत्युक्त प्रस्थितो दूतो यथावद् वदत् नृपान् तेपि संदर्शनम शौरेः
pratyaikshan yan mukush mumukshavaha. And then, turning to the messenger of the imprisoned kings, that the one who had come from Girivraja, the kingdom of Jarasan, to that messenger, Bhagavan Shri Krishna spoke to him, go and tell the kings that they should fear no more, because the death of Jarasan is very near. So, ashwasan, words of comfort, that don't worry, it will happen. And why will it happen? Not only because a tattva darshi, Uddhava, has said, but now it is being backed by Shri Krishna himself. He is also Satya Sankalpa. See, Satya Sankalpa, you know what it is? Once... Bhagwan is like Kalpavriksha. Kalpavriksha, you understand? You have heard of it? Kalpavriksha is that tree under which all your wishes are satisfied. But our problem is, why the Lord is not satisfying our wish? Isn't it? We are living in this world, we are dedicated to the Lord, we chant the name of the Lord, we come to the satsangs, and we light the lamp, we morning, evening, or at least the lamp is lighted in our heart about Him. But then why our wish is not satisfied? Once a person went and he was tired, exhausted, thirsty, sunny, and he found himself under a tree. He did not know that it was a Kalpavriksha. अपने इंडिया में कल्पवृक्ष किसको बोलते हैं? नीम के पेड़ को, बरगद के पेड़ को, द बनियन ट्री और द नॉट नीम ट्री सॉरी द पीपल ट्री. यू नो पीपल डाई द थ्रेड देयर, दैट इज द रीजन, बिकॉज दे अंडर इट इफ यू आर देयर योर विशेज विल बी फुलफिल्ड. सो दिस फेलो केम अंडर द ट्री एंड ही सेज, ओ माय गॉड, आई एम सो टायर्ड, आई विश आई हैड अ ग्लास ऑफ, वेयर विल आई गेट, इमीडिएटली अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर अपीयर्स. पानी पी लिया उसने, I wish I had another glass of water. Another glass of water appears. He drank that also. Are? Something magic going on. I'm getting whatever I want. I wish I had some food. Immediately a buffet is appeared for him. Ah, now my tummy is full. I wish there was a bed to rest. Immediately bed. And while he's sleeping, lying down, I hope there are no ghosts here who will come and devour me. Immediately the ghosts come and devour him. Now, what is the fault of Kalpavriksha? Whose fault is it? The fellow with his desires. His desires are wrong. Kalpavriksha will give whatever you desire. So when we are interacting with the Lord who is of the nature of Kalpavriksha, why do you blame God? It is your mistake. What? Because your desire is wrong when you are talking to Him. We only want something from this world. And as long as your attention is on this body and this world, you will come out of fear, insecurity, jealousy. See? And we say, nicely we say, I wish I don't get angry. I don't hate anybody. You are concentrating on hate. And you are wishing, where is your attention? On the Lord, on the love, or on the negative. So don't blame Lord for anything in life. What is your angle of interaction with the Lord? That alone. So just like the internet is everywhere, you take your phone. If you open a YouTube app, you will get YouTube. If you open a Google app, it will open Google only. If you open Time app, it will show you the time. But in Time app, you can, why this app is opening? I thought internet is everywhere. Internet's fault is not there. It is all-pervading. Lord is also all-pervading. With what desire you interact with Him, that will get fulfilled. I wish, for many years now, my life is going very good. I hope it doesn't go bad. Gaya. So what did you wish? I wish it doesn't go bad. Your attention is, why these type of comments come out of our mind? Because our attention is on the world. Our attention is not on the Lord. Yes, Lord is there in the background, but you're coming out of fear. You're coming out of fear of duality. You are still thinking you are a product of this whole creation. You are not created a relationship with the Lord that, oh Lord, I am at your disposal, I am at your feet, and I don't want to understand or not understand anything about this world. This world is nothing but you. I don't understand it right now, but I don't want to be concerned about it. I only want to be dedicated to your feet. Be single-pointedly focused on his feet. Or Atma Chintan, both is the same thing. Then see, Satya Sankalpa, how will it not happen? And in this way, the Lord gave an assurance to all the kings that Jarasandh will be killed, it will be taken care of, and not too far away. And then the messenger, he departed and conveyed the message to the kings. And what were those kings doing there when they got the message from the messenger? They started incessantly, deeply, lovingly thinking of the Lord from that moment on. They were thinking of him, but now they have got a direct message from the Lord himself. What did Ajamil do once he got the message from the Parshadas? He dedicated whatever, he didn't know how long he was going to live, but he dedicated his entire life after that incident to the remembrance of the Lord. So why we want to wait for such incident to happen in our life? Better start right now. And whatever has to happen in life, that will happen. You cannot change it. If you are meant to be married, it will happen. If you are meant to, if this body is meant to die, nobody can stop it. So take advantage of what is there right now. And that opportunity that we have as a human being is to realize that we are not other than the Lord. This world is not other than the Lord. We have to develop that vision. And this opportunity is given only in the human form. Only for the human beings. No other species in this world, in this creation, can come to that point. Even if they are extraterrestrial, they have to come to this life in order to, on earth. Kafi aa rahe aajkal, 8 billion. So opportunity is given, but what happens? Instead of remembering the Lord, we get lost in the world. Continuing.
Anarth sauviramaruhu tirtva vinashanam harihi girin nadirati aya pura grama vrajakaran tato drushadvatim tirtva mukundoth saraswatim panchalanath matsyascha shakra prasthamathagamata tamupagatamakarnya prito durdharshanam nrunam ajata shatrur nirgata sopadhyaya suhrudvruta gita vaditra ghoshena brahma ghoshena bhuyasa abhyayat sarushikesham prana pranamivadudruta drushtva viklin hrudayah krushnam snehena pandavah chiradrushtum priyatamam sasvajetha punah punah dorbhyam parishvajya ramamalalayam mukundaghatram drupatir hatashubham lebhe param nirvritimashrulo chano rashyantanur विस्मृतलोक विभ्रमः तम्मातुलेयं परिरभ्य निर्वृतो भीमस्मयन् प्रेमजवा कुलेन्द्रियः यमौ किरीटी च सुरुत्तमं मुदा प्रवृद्ध बाष्पापरिरे भिरेच्युतम् अर्जुनेन परिष्वक्तो यमाभ्यामभिवादितः ब्राह्मणेभ्यो नमस्कृत्य वृद्धेभ्यश्च यथार्हतः मानितो मानयामास कुरुसृञ्जय कैकयान् सूतमागधगन्धर्वा वन्दिनश्चोपमन्त्रिणः मृदङ्गशङ्खपटः वीणापणवगोमुखैः ब्राह्मणाश्चारविन्दाक्षं तुष्टुवुर्ननृतुर्जगुः एवं सुहृद्भिः पर्यस्तः पुण्यश्लोकशिखामणिः संस्तूयमानो भगवान् विवेशालङ्कृतं पुरम् And this entire caravan of Krishna Bhagavan, along with his wives and sons, as it passes through the lands of Anartha, Sauvira, Maru, Kurukshetra, and crossing many hills and rivers, Bhagavan Shri Krishna went past many towns, villages, cowherds, hamlets, mines, and quarries. And then eventually crossing the Drishtavati and Saraswati rivers. In those days, Saraswati river was not where it is today. Here today it is found only in two, three places. One is in Badrinath. From Badrinath, if you go 7 kilometers to the north, towards the Tibet border, there is a village called Managaon. And at Managaon, out of a huge mountain, you can go there. There is just one hole as big as this room. And from there, the river is coming out. And just about 1.5 kilometers long, that's all. And it joins the Alaknanda. So, and then it goes, they say it goes underground and everything. And then in Punjab it is seen. And then in Rajasthan also, some part of it appears. Originally it used to go all the way to the Arabian Sea Peninsula, the bay. But because it has climate change, it has vanished. So this, he passed through the kingdoms of Panchala and Matsya and finally reached Indraprastha. And at the site of Krishna Bhagwan, at the front of the entire caravan, when Yudhishthira saw, he was so delighted that he ran out of the palace to the gates of the Indraprastha city along with the friends and priests and relations, and he could not contain the joy that the Lord has come, the Lord Shri Krishna has come. Because you may take him to be the Lord. At that time, Arjuna was still not convinced, probably, because that's why Bhagavad Gita took place. But in Yudhishthira's mind, it was very clear that this Lord Shri Krishna, he is something extraordinary. Nobody had the powers, nobody had the acumen, nobody had the diplomacy, nobody had the abilities and capabilities that Krishna showed in his life. From childhood, they have heard the stories of Krishna, that he did this, he did that, he did this. How can a normal human being do that? So he was being a Dharmatma Yudhishthira, he had something clicked inside of him as regards Shri Krishna. Bhim Maharaj, he is totally in love with Krishna because he is the elder brother. You always love the younger one. The Bhagavad Gita took place only because of the confusion. Confusion was with Arjuna. Neither elder nor younger. If you are younger, you are surrendered to the elder. If you are elder, you protect the younger. But Arjuna is in between. So he was so excited and so thrilled that he lost all senses and he came there to meet our Shri Krishna, along with sounds and trumpets and musical instruments and loud the recitation of the Vedic hymns and everything was by the Brahmanas that was going on. And the moment his eyes saw the Lord Krishna, it was as if he has never breathed in his life before, as if life entered anew into him. He started crying, he lost his mind. He was so thrilled. And in this way, and he hugged the Lord again and again, again and again. And the Lord also reciprocated too by hugging and caressing his back and head. Because Yudhishthira is elder to the Lord. But in that moment, this overflowing of love, he embraced the Lord, and then while this was going on, all the other brothers are also there. The mere proximity of the Lord, the mere touch of the Lord, being in the embrace of the Lord, removed all the sins from Yudhishthira. When I used to take the children's class, I used to tell the children, imagine Shri Krishna is sitting. I have done that meditation with you people also. You should not imagine Lord Shri Krishna in your meditation to be a murti or a picture. He should be a living person. And how do you see it as a living person? His eyes should be blinking, his smile, his mouth should be smiling, his clothes should be fluttering in the breeze, his hair going this way or sometimes that way, and you should see yourself moving in his direction. And when you go in his direction, he is opening as you are going close to him, he is opening his arms out to embrace you, and you run into, and the children, I used to love it so much. They are all their eyes closed and they are imagining all this. And they are going into his arms, and then I used to say, now he's picked you up, and they are doing like this in the meditation, that he's picking them up. And they will sit in his, now he's keeping you on his lap, and he's caressing your head, and they are so much. And then he's asking, tell me child, what do you want? And then this used to be the best one. Someone says, I want a truck, I want a cycle, I want a chocolate. And then I started not asking, giving them that option. Then I said, okay, first time you asked, now you ask for Shraddha, Bhakti, knowledge, I should be a good child, I should be all those positive ones. But when you have a live Lord, not a statue Lord, not an inert Lord in your mind, then the interaction is at a different level. Then it is real for you, even if it is imagination. Imagination for those intellectuals. But our Yoga Sutra says, Drishyanuvit Savikalpa Samadhi. Drishyanuvit or Vitarkanugat Savikalpa. Savikalpa. Vikalpa means with a thought. Savikalpa with a thought. Thought of what? Drishya. Drishya is an image. But not an inert image. It is a alive, living image of the Lord. And when you interact with that, it will take, because now it is not I am separate and the image. No, kuch bhi nahi ho raha yaar, wo to kuch bol hi nahi raha hai, kuch kar nahi raha hai. So it has to be a with life. And when you interact with that, very quickly meditation happens, absorption happens. And in this way, this then Bhimsen Maharaj, he comes and he also hugs the Lord, and he is also transported with joy. And then Arjuna, this all, in those days, everything happened according to hierarchy. First the Raja, the elder brother, then the younger. After Bhima, who was there? Arjuna. After Arjuna, Nakul and Sahadev, they also touched his feet and came into his arms and hugged the Lord. And then Shri Krishna did not stop there. Then he bowed to the Brahmins who were there chanting all the Vedic mantras. And in this way, honored by the Kurus, Shrinjayas, and Kaikayas, the Lord duly returned the honors to the Sutas, Magadhas, Gandharvas, and Gandharvas, bards and court jesters. He acknowledged to everyone, and then surrounded by friends and well-wishers, the Lord, the foremost among those of sacred renown, entered the decorated city while all this chanting and praising was going on. And the moment he entered the city, what does he find? That the entire city of Indraprastha was absolutely at its best, decorated, the scented water sprinkled by the elephants all over the roads, the houses full of flowers, everyone dressed at their best. And that is what is explained in the next few verses. And all the people in absolutely washed and ironed clothes, looking at their best, having all the ornaments, garlands, men, and all the people, nobody was sitting inside the house. Ah, ho jayega, aane do yaar, mahatma hi to hai. God, Lord, theek hai, koi baat nahi, jaane do, wo to Yudhishthir ko milne aaye, aise nahi. हम भी ऐसे ही कहते हैं ना, महात्मा आया है मेलबर्न, हाँ बहुत आते रहते हैं, कहते हैं ना, हम भी ऐसे ही कहते हैं. सो नो एवरीवन, बिकॉज द स्टेचर ऑफ द लॉर्ड इज इनकम्पेरेबल. टाइम क्या हो गया? ठीक बता देना मेरे को, 8:30. एंड देयरफॉर एवरीवन हैज हर्ड हिज ग्लोरी. So everyone is out on the streets welcoming Lord Krishna and his entire caravan. And I will not read all this. Tatra-tatropa-sangamya paura-mangala-pahnayaha chakru-saparyam-krishnaya shreni-mukhya-hatayinasaha. This is the 37th verse. And as he enters into the city, all the roads are singing his glory and everything. The roads were crowded with elephants, horses, chariots, pedestrians, women, and everyone. All these women, as they looked at Krishna, they started feeling, the comments were, how come, what have these ladies who are his wives, what have they done that they deserve Krishna? Why can't we deserve Krishna? So these type of comments were heard. And then they say, what meritorious deeds have been performed by these ladies that they have got Shri Krishna as their husband. And in this wonderment, their eyes could not leave Shri Krishna's form. And wherever he was going, they were following him. And here, and all the prominent citizens, and the senior citizens and the leaders and all the carpenters, the welders, the blacksmiths, etc., everyone was there. Even though they had just come out of their workplaces, like that only they offered their prayers to the Lord Shri Krishna. And by that, this was the intention of Yudhishthir, that he wanted to invite Shri Krishna so that Krishna's presence itself gives the blessings to all the people. You see, that was his intention, and that is exactly what is happening. And understand this, just like you all left India to come here for a new opportunity, similarly Indraprastha was also a land of new opportunity. Everyone who It was before Yudhishthir was sent to Indraprastha, he announced in the Hastinapur that whoever wants to come to this God-forsaken land, that time it was absolutely Khandavaprastha. The name was Khandavaprastha. Khandavaprastha means it was, even today some of it is there. Go towards the airport, all the Aravali hills, rocks, barren land, no water. No water, and that, and he says, we will build a new land here where new kingdom where everyone lives with respect to each other. We all need all different, but nobody is higher and lower, but everyone is everyone is respected. No corruption in Hastinapur, very long established, too much corruption. So this was the new land, and all these people had come, and now they are getting the darshan of the Lord himself. Then continuing from 38th verse, antapura janai pritya mukunda fulla lochanaihi sasambhramairabhyupetaha praveshad rajamandiram prudhavilokya bhatreyam krishnam tribhuvaneshwaram prithatma prithatmothaya paryankat sasrusha parishashvaje govindam gruhamaniva deva devesh shamadutaha drutaha pujayam navidat krutyam pramodopahato nrupaha pitrushvasur guru srinam krishnashchakre bhivadanam swayam chakrushnaya rajan bhaginya chabhivanditaha shvashrava sanchodita krishna krishna patnishcha sarvashaha anarcha rukminim satyam bhadram jambavati tatha kalindim mitravindam cha shaibhyam nagnajitim satim anyascha bhyagatayastu vasasrang mandanadibihi sukham nivasayamasa dharmarajo janardanam sasainyam sanugamyatvam sabharyam cha navam navam tarpayitva khandavena vahnim falguna sayutaha mochayitva mayam yena rajne divya sabhakruta uvasakyati chinmasan rajne priya chikirshaya viharan rathamaruhya falgunena bhatair vrutaha. And as he passed through the city of Indraprastha and reached the palace, and all the people, after having welcomed Krishna Bhagavan at the beginning, all the Pandavas and everyone, they came back for a proper welcome with aarti, varti, all the rigmarole at the palace. And Bhagavan Shri Krishna came to the palace, and there Kuntiji came first, and the moment she saw her brother's son, because Vasudevji is cousin brother of Kunti. And her eyes filled with tears, and immediately she went along with her daughter-in-law Draupadi and gave an embrace to the Lord. And then King Yudhishthira, again, first time he got, but now he's even more. He came and again he came and he has brought Shri Krishna, the ruler, what is that? And did not know how to proceed with the worship. He was so dumbstruck. He was so full of love for Lord Krishna that pair chhu ke hug karu ke aarti karu ke kya karu or kya na karu. He was totally, he did not know the sequence which one to follow, and he did whatever came to him. And then Krishna also touched the feet of his aunt Kunti and other elderly people who have come together there. Who were the elderly? We told you, the Gandharvas, the Draupadi's parents are there, and Matsya Raja is there, and so many others are there. And and after having prostrated or done namaskar to the elders, Draupadi and Subhadra, which is the younger sister of Shri Krishna, they did namaskar to Shri Krishna, and under the direction of her mother-in-law Draupadi, she honored all the main wives of Shri Krishna. Who are they? Eight of them. They are Rukmini, Satyabhama, Bhadra, Jambavati, Kalindi, Mitravinda, Lakshmana, and Satya. And not only them, they also offered to all those who had come, all the other wives, they offered them all the garlands, costumes, and various articles of beauty. So how do you make the vinegar woman's heart? Give lipstick. Not to your brother, to you. Lipstick, powder, kajal, all this they appreciate. They never get tired of it. And then the great king, the virtuous king Yudhishthira, he gave accommodation to Shri Krishna along with his wives and his entire army. And where did he give him accommodation? You know, imagine a hotel in which you got the best beds and the best anything, and every day the menu is different. Every day the games that you are playing is different. Every day all the swimming pool changes shape, the all the various games of play, the movies are different, the games are different. Every day new things are being presented to you to keep you entertained. Such was the place given by Yudhishthira to Shri Krishna and his wives and the entire army, so that they feel at home. And then after that, in the 45th verse, he says, Tarpayitva khandavena vahnim falguna sanyutaha yo mochayitva bhayam mayam yena rajne divya sabhakruta. And then Shri Krishna, he used to go for hunting, and all that used to happen. And one day Krishna Bhagavan and Arjuna, they went to Khandava forest, not Khandava Prat, but Khandava forest, and there they rescued Maya from the god of fire by putting. And this Mayasur, who was rescued by Arjuna from the burning of the forest, he said, what can I do for you? And Shri Krishna asked him, build the palace for the Pandavas. So he built the beautiful palace where the floors were like water and the water was like the marble floors. And very, very unique rooms were there. And in one of them, we know afterwards, Duryodhan, he thinks that it is floor, marble floor, and he puts his step and he falls down into the water, and Draupadi is watching from up there, and she says, Andheka beta andha. And the problem has started from there. Then, Uvasa kati chinmasan rajnya priya chikirshaya viharan radhamaruhya falgunena bhatair vrutaha. And wanting to please King Yudhishthir, the Lord spent several months. He spent about four or six months there in Indraprastha, or maybe longer. Every day he used to go out with Arjuna for hunting and seeing the various parts of the land. And this way, iti Srimad Bhagavate Mahapuran Paramahamsyam Samhitaya Dashamaskande Uttararde Krishnasyendra Prasthagamane Nama Eka Saptatitamodhyayaha. With this, we conclude the 71st chapter of the 10th canto, and we enter into the 72nd. And what happens in 72nd chapter, we'll see it in our next episode, which will be next week. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate
Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.